so much for coming in. My sister and business partner will be here shortly. She's running a little bit late. But while I'm with you, I would like to express my gratitude for answering our Craigslist ad. None of our employees were willing to participate with this new product. And I'm so grateful that you were willing to, because I think it could be really beneficial for our industry. Before I get started, I do need you to sign a couple waivers and confidentiality stuff, okay? It's just silly paperwork. Okay, so sign right here. And right here. Okay, I also need you to sign right here. Sure you don't want to read it? It's a bunch of legal jargon. So let me just make sure that that's it. Okay, and just put your initials and the date right here. This little shop that was kind of out of the way. She went by the name MF. And I can't wait to show it to you. It's pretty neat. It's supposed to provide rapid hair growth. So then we can hone our skills with hair washing, cutting, and styling on you. Okay? Oh. This is the tonic. Kind of fancy, but I think people will like it. People like embellishments. But it's neat. So I'm going to apply this hair tonic on you. Oh, first let me put on some gloves, because I don't want to grow hair out of my hands. Just play. Alright. Do you answer a lot of ads on Craigslist? Okay, ready. Okay, so I'm going to apply the tonic to your scalp and we'll see what happens. I'll try a little bit in the beginning and go from there. Just put that back in its very special case. More. really interested in seeing how this comes together. I was pretty skeptical when Madam MF said it could. Cause hair to grow almost instantly, but do you know there's so many advancements in technology, and who knows, maybe she found a new protein or hair that when applied rapidly stimulates hair growth. I'm not a scientist, so I can't say. Should feel good for you anyway, right? You get a free scalp massage either way. I think if it works, it'll be really good, because we can just grow out everyone's hair as long as they want it. They cut it as short as they want it. We have to wrap it up with some hair wrap, and then as soon as it's all insulated, supposed to count to 30, and supposedly in 30 seconds or so you should have some hair, or lots of it, who knows. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, I'm just looking, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, I don't see anything. 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22. I feel like I can hear it growing. 23, 24, 25. Whoa. 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. Let's unwrap this. So, it worked. I'm just going to take off the hair wrap. Okay. Other side. Feel any different? Okay. All right, let me take off my gloves. Wait, it's basket. Okay, well, we have a lot to work with.
Oh my God, what have you done?
Nothing we can't handle. I think I might have used a little too much tonic, but it's hair. We can fix that super fast. So, could you wash the hair for me while I go get some supplies?
But the eyebrows and the nose.
Okay, so she's going to wash her hair and I will be back to do the cut. Okay, I'll see you soon.
Okay. Hey there. I'm going to put a cool towel over your eyes before I do your wash. Okay. Ready? Close your eyes, please. Alright, put your head back for me. Alright. Let me know how the water is. Especially if it's too cold, because I don't seem to be the most intuitive with appropriate water temperature. The cold never bothered me anyway. Okay, just need to lean over you a little bit so I can wash your hair. Sister's never been shy about telling me where I need improvement. been working on bettering my customer service, particularly my small talk and the way I socialize. I think that I've made some progress. I feel like I've gotten a lot more tactful. I really don't know how else to tell you that your eyebrows look like glorious lion manes, and I'm pretty sure I could put your nose hair into a formal braid. So, while she's cutting your hair, I'm going to give you a trim and pluck. Because it's like Rapunzel put her hair into pigtails and she's waiting for a prince to climb up your face and rescue her from your nose. Sit up for me. Looks really clean. the smock is on really well. Okay. Alright, I'm just going to take off the cold towel. Feel alright? Good.
Okay, so I'm going to brush out your hair and section it off. Get started on your cut.
Okay. So, just stay still. Gonna do your nose. One nostril down. Don't breathe for a second. Okay. Now to do those brows. Holding your skin taut, so I don't pull it unnecessarily. You have to pull in the direction that the hair grows. And give you more shape. Not so bad. Pluck. 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 Oh, sorry. That one's a bit tenacious. It's sticking like bubble gum. Okay. Going to have to use my alarming strength to do it. So I'm gonna count down with you. Ready? 3, 2, 1. Got it. Much better. Now it doesn't look like there could be ninjas hiding in the shrubbery of your eyebrows anymore. Good. Okay. I'll be back to blow out your hair.
Hair's getting a little staticky in the back. Hang on, I have some oil for that. There we go. Okay, that should be better. brush it off your eye. There. I hate when that gets on your skin. It tickles, doesn't it? Give you a little bit of a fringe, as they say across the pond. Oh, I could do this all day. I never get tired. My right arm is a lot stronger than my left, so I can cut all day. Tugging on it, making sure that it's all even around. Just involves a lot of comparing ends. Using my fingers. One leg. Not too hard. Okay, so I'm going to leave you to my sister. Let me just brush that off. Just getting it off. Your shoulders and your clothes. Let me take the smock off you. You won't have any stray hairs on you. That's better. My sister's going to blow out your hair a little bit, style it, give it some hold.
I'm gonna whip your hair back and forth.
I will. I'll be back. Alright, just to see how it finishes up. Make any. In a bit.
Okay, ready? Just going to style it. Give it some body bounce. Some va-va-boom. Alright, let's try it. Just whip it. I just need to spray some product in your hair. Give it a little bit of hold. Do the trick. It smells really good.
There you are. Found you through all that hair. All finished. Yeah, it looks pretty great.
Your face looks a lot better.
As promised, through the ad, your next 5 haircuts are on us. That includes any styling you want, blowouts, treatments, whatever, for really assisting us today and honoring everything that you signed.
Sorry about the supernatural hair growth.
Hopefully we'll see you soon. Bye.
See ya.
Hello everyone, it's me, Heather Feather. I want to take this opportunity to explain something with you that's going to be happening involving my channel. After months of requests, I am starting a Patreon account. Patreon is a way to support content creators for their hard work via regular donations. Now, before I go any farther, I want to explicitly state and emphasize that no matter what happens with this Patreon account, even if I don't get a single penny, I'm still going to be creating content for you on YouTube for free. That is not changing. I'm not taking anything away. I will always be here making content for you. I love making ASMR videos. Probably more than is reasonable. It's something that I am truly passionate about, and I wouldn't give it up for the world. I love it more than you will probably ever know. And I know that when people talk about money and ASMR, sometimes people can feel angry, frightened even, or just very concerned. And I get that. I am an ASMR video consumer myself. I understand the different perspectives. I didn't make this decision lightly. It took me 5 months to decide to do this. But I did it because I think Patreon could really help my channel. I have really big plans for my videos. Specifically with Candy Queen, After the Battle, and Mystical Feather. I want to bring these stories to life in the way that I see them in my head, and I have lots of other stories in my head that I want to tell you and show you and immerse you in. I have so much in store for the Mystical Feather series. A lot of you have caught on that I have been hiding Easter eggs in a ton of my role plays since before the summer about Mystical Feather, and that was deliberate. I have big things in store for her involving lots of new characters you have yet to meet and crossovers with other characters that I've already created. So, crossovers in the Featherverse. She's my most morally ambiguous character, and her storyline is really interesting, and I want to bring the magic to the story since she is mystical via special effects, visual effects. I watch tutorials at night, almost every night. I'm learning as I go. I want to create ASMR videos that not only trigger your faces off, but are as immersive as they can possibly be while making you smile, making you tingle, helping you relax, helping you sleep. I want you to forget that you're watching a YouTube video. I want to create an escape for you for when the world gets too loud. Though I have been lucky enough to have the best people on the internet cheering me on, offering me advice, feedback, motivation, inspiration, ideas, the burden of cost of making videos, be it on things as small as lithium batteries and press-on nails every week, to lighting, software, green screen, electrical equipment, computers, and most importantly, time, falls solely on me. I spend as much time making ASMR videos a week as most people spend on their full-time job, sometimes more. And I have a full-time job. I make 2 videos a week, and I'm always looking for ways to improve, specifically with immersion. Since I started my channel, I've gone through 2 laptops, 3 portable hard drives, or they're called passports. I call them passports. And my desktop, which is less than a year old, which I bought for my channel last year, is on its last leg now. My videos are long. The HD visuals that you see are much longer before I edit them down. Add that to however many audio tracks I'm using for a video at the moment, and you have a massive amount of space being taken up, not only by the individual parts for a video, but then by the finished product. By becoming my patron, which is what you'd be called if you supported my Patreon, you can help me have access to new, faster, and higher quality equipment, which would give me the ability to bring the visions I have for my videos to life via new software, new recording techniques, locations, collaborations, etc. New resources can help me create videos more efficiently, allowing me time to create, edit, experiment, sleep. Which will not only improve the quality of my work, but the quality of your experience of it. I want to branch out from being so dependent on the unreliability of YouTube for the income to support my channel endeavors. I love YouTube. I love being a YouTuber more than anything, but I'm very much at the whims of advertisers, glitches, which happen all the time. False flaggers, people who use Adblock, networks who put false copyright claims on other people's material in order to hijack their revenue. Patreon will hopefully alleviate the stress of these inconsistencies and frustrations. If you become my patron, you get rewards. I thought about these for a long time. I wanted to do rewards that were feasible for me, based on my time constraints and my comfort boundaries. Patreon divides rewards by amounts, and my rewards include a private Patreon stream where I will be updating frequently about my progress, maybe pictures, whatever my ASMR heart desires at the moment. Having your name at the end of 1 video each month in the credits as thank you. having access to a private subreddit where I will be chatting with you about ASMR videos that I'm digging, ASMR artists that I really admire at the moment, my own content, maybe some spontaneous Q&As, a vote every now and then on an object you might like to see in a future video, stuff like that. Some patrons will get MP3s of the previous month's videos, so every video I put out that month, they will get MP3s for it to enjoy whenever they want. Some patrons will get 30-second personalized audio clips for you, your friends, your family, and 1 hour live Google Hangout. Details are all on my Patreon page, and the link for that is in the About section of this video. I have been blessed to have the most supportive, encouraging, and kind people as my viewers and my friends on my YouTube journey. No matter what happens with Patreon, I'm still going to be here making ASMR videos for you, for free, on YouTube. If you can donate, any amount will be greatly appreciated. Every penny is significant. But if you can't donate, it doesn't make me any less grateful to have you as part of my team. Thank you so much for even considering it.